Hello and welcome to another RPA tutorial video. Today in this video, I'm going to talk about automation anywhere V11.3 control room. So here, basically, I'm going to explain you about automation anywhere 11.3. What are the new features available in this version, along with like some live examples. I will show you how to create role, how to create how to deploy the bot, those things. Okay. So basically, this video will take two parts. So I'll create first part where I will explain all the components which is available in Automation Anywhere V11.3. And after that, in next part, I will show you how to create credential, how to deploy bots. Okay. So I will discuss in details and I will try to show you the demo based on the real-time examples, which will help you. So those who are very new to this channel, please note, like I'm using this channel to create different types of video based on RPA using Automation Anywhere and the UI path. And if you are interested to learn RPA, I would request you to kindly refer to my other videos, which will help you to learn about the RPA. Another thing before starting this discussion is, in case if you are looking for a complete end-to-end RPA project development or RPA project support, or if you are looking for Automation Anywhere or UI part training, so kindly you can contact us in the mentioned mail ID, which is rpa.developers1@gmail.com. So we'll be very happy to help you people. All right, so let's start the discussion. Okay, so let me go to the control room. Okay, so this is the Automation Anywhere control room V11.3. So due to some reason, I'm not able to display you this particular options, which is dashboards. Okay, so probably this is a problem happening with my system. Currently, I'm using Windows 10. So might be due to some reason, my system is not able to validate this token. So it is getting authorization is getting failed. But no problem. So in next video, I will look into it and I'll try to explain you about this part. So I can give you a little bit knowledge on these components. If you see this Automation Anywhere, so they designed this control room new version in very nice way. So if you see the dashboard here, we can see the information. It will provide the details view of the entire automations in a graphical insight. So in this particular page, so you will see all the details about your bots, device, audits, workload, and the insights. Okay. So currently I'm not going in more details because we are not able to see the details. Okay. So probably I'll fix this issue as soon as possible and I'll create a separate video based on this dashboard. All right. Okay. Now moving to the next component, which is activity. So under activities tab, we have three informations available. So first one is in progress, schedule, and the histogram. So in process, in progress will give you the details about the bot. Let's say if you run a bot, you are scheduling any bot. So in case if you want to check the status of your bot, so you can check it from here. So let's say your bot is running for 30 minutes. Okay. So if you come to this section, you can see the percentage of completion, which we can see from here. This in progress will show you. I will demonstrate this part also. Okay. Once we will move to the part two. Okay. The schedule will help you to schedule a bot. So if you click on schedule a bot, so it will give you the options to select the bot which you want to schedule. Okay. So let me click here. I can show you, right? So basically this schedule part is taking you to a different tab. From there you can select your bots and dependent file. Okay, now coming to the historical tab. So historical tab will give you the details about all the bot has been scheduled or run from the control room. So it will give you the basically historical data from this tab. Okay, now moving to the another component, which is bots. Okay, so in bots, you can see we have two options available. One is bots and another is the credential. In the bot section, you can see, so bot section is basically giving you the details about the folder and the task which you have developed using the Automation Anywhere client. So currently I'm having this one task. So that task is there in this client. You can see this is the task which I have uploaded into the client control room. So which is there in my task. Okay, so if you come here and you can see here in my task, I'm having this POC task, right? So I can see from here. in case if you have anything which is available in your documents, or if you have any meta bot, you can view from this my bot. So from here, like, you can do many things apart from viewing our bots or the other files, dependent files. You can see, like, you can, if you want to import or export bots, that also you can do it from here. After selecting your bot, in case if you want to run, okay, you can schedule. So this many things you can perform using this my bot tab. Now coming to the credential, in case if you have any credential or you have created any credential in control room, so that you can see from here. Okay, so if you click on the create a credential, so it will ask you to provide the details. So this is one of the difference from the control room 10 and the 11 is, like, you know, credential. They have now in 11 version, the credential is more secure because you have to create the locker. And here, like, you know, we have some options available, like standard and user provided credential, mask, and this is the password. So, like, you know, options are more available in terms of, like, you know, if you compare with the 10 with the 11, okay. So in terms of this credential part, this is more secure. Okay, so now let me close this. Here you can see the other options available, like my locker credential request, in case if you have any credential request, so which will you can see from here. Okay, the my locker. So I will keep a separate video on this, like how to create credential, how to work with my locker, this credential request, everything I will send, because this is one of the important feature of Automation Anywhere V11. Okay. All right, now moving to the next section, which is device. Okay, so in device section, you can see the bot runner or bot creator, whatever is available, okay, or like, you know, using your credential which you created from this control room. If you logged in using those credentials, you can see from here. So currently I logged in with this system, okay. This is my basically a bot creator. You can see the type, you can see here as a bot creator, okay. So it will give you the device name, username, etc., right? Now, so here, in case if you have any other device which is connected, like your bot runner or other, other dev systems, okay? So you can view from here. So this device tab will provide you the entire information about the device which is available for this automation, okay? Now, coming to my device pool. So my device pool is all about a group of device or group of bot runners, okay, which we are creating using this page, okay. So which we are using at the time of using the workload management. So this my device pool will help you to create, like, you know, select multiple device, okay, and during the workload management activities you can use those device to run your bot. So from here, if you want to run any bots, you can see you have the options: run bot now, schedule bot, run bot with the queue, okay. So you can run bot from here also. All right, now moving to the next section, which is workload. So this is very important and another features which added in 11. Okay, so workload is all about your distributing your work between, like, you know, multiple bot runners. So let's say, for example, you have a 10,000 records, okay, which you want to process using one bot runner, okay. So I'm assuming, like, you know, to complete a 10,000 record, one bot runner will take 12 hours to complete. But due to process requirement, you want to complete that work in a 6 hours only, right? So with the help of one bot runner, it's not possible. However, if you use the workload management, so it will help you to distribute your work, okay? If you have, like, multiple bot runners, you can create a logic. Those logic will help to process your task by dividing into the two bot runners, okay? So this is the new features available. So here, like, you have to define a queue. Once you have defined the queue, you have to put the details. So I will explain this part also in upcoming videos. Now the SLA calculator will help you to calculate the, like, you know, number of bot runner is needed to complete that particular task, okay? All right, now coming to one of the important features, which is audit log. So here, like, the audit log is almost same only, but they have added some more information here. You can use, like, you know, filter, like if you want to filter for last 24 hours, 70 days, 90 days, okay? So you can select these options, so it will display the value of audit log activities here, okay? And in case if you want to export, the audit log data, you can try and try from here, like you can export into the CSV. So this audit log will give you the overview and the details about the your activities which is happening in Automation Anywhere control room as well as the client. Okay, you can see here I logged into the client. It is logged as like client logged in. I uploaded a bot, so this activity is also updated into the client log. So this many things, like I restarted some services, I went to the credential vault, so all these things is updating into the audit log. Okay, now coming to the most important and useful part of the control room is administration. So here in administration, you can see we have multiple options available, like settings, user roles, license, and migration. So let me click on the settings. So within settings, you can see we have like six options available. General, if you go to the general tab, you can get the details about your configuration of the Automation Anywhere control room. Okay, so here you can see I have did the installation using the express type of installation. Okay, so this express type of installation is installation method where in one system we are installing everything. Let's say I'm having a SQL server, control room, and the client. So I'm installing everything in this one system only. So this basically express method of installation will help you to do a POC. Okay, it will helpful for the learning purpose, right? So you can see this is my control room link. Okay, you can see the details, like when did I last modify. Okay, and here you can get the control room database and the server details. Okay, so in case if you have the access, you can go ahead and check this part. These are very important part. Okay, all right, now I'm moving to the next part, which is a bot. So here in this bot section, you can get information about the version control. Okay, so version control is like, there are some softwares available in the market which will help you to control your version. So let's say you have developed a bot and which you have uploaded in the control room, right? So let's say as per the process, you have to make some changes and again upload that bot. Okay, so in that time, version control will help you to keep repository or like details of your other bot. Okay, so which will keep a copy of your bot. So once you next time upload the bot, it will ask you to provide some proper details, like why you have uploaded along with the details, like check in, check out, those details. Okay, so currently I'm not using any of the subversion, okay, or the version control. So if you use, you'll have like details available here. Okay. Okay, now coming to the client applications. So here if you can see the options are available, like configuration. Okay, so here in case if you want to use a secure recording, so secure recording you can only activate from this part only. Okay, you have to come to the like client applications, and here if I click here on the edit part, okay, you can see like I got the access. If I want to enable this secure recording, I have to click on. So similarly, in case if you want to make some changes with this part, okay, you can go ahead and make the changes from here. Okay. Now coming to the credentials. So credential part is like, at the time of installing your control room, okay, so there you have to put your user details, right? So basically here you're setting the credential vault. So setting up a credential vault, we have two methods. One is manual, another is express. So I use the express. Okay, so there like we got a master key. So from this page, you can get to know how or the what method we have used to set up the credential vault. Okay. All right, now coming to the email section. So this email section will give you information about sending email. So let's say if you want to send an email using control room. Okay, so here if I'm saying sending email using control room means, so you can see we have some options available here. So let's say in case if any user logged his account, okay, his or her account, so how you are going to like reset that things and all, or like, if being a control room admin, if you're making some changes to any of the accounts or you're adding any user into the control room, okay, like if you're giving like a bot runner or bot creator access. So if you check this box, it will trigger an email to the user, okay, stating that like your account has been created, etc., etc., okay. So this will also help you in case if your bot is running and it got failed or it got completed. So control room will help you to send the email to the concerned persons. So, you know, notify the bot got successful or got failed. So to use the control room email part, you have to fill the details like your email address, your email host, port, and other details. Then you can, like, you know, you'll be able to use this email function. So now coming to the last section of the admin part is, like, you know, like this is a system log part. So basically whenever you are doing anything into the automation anywhere, it is generating log for each and every activity. Okay, so if you want to put some details or if you want to put in a server of those system details, you have to put your details like server name, port, protocol, etc. Okay. So guys, I make sure, like, I'll create a video based on the practical things like user creation, roles, okay, license and all. Okay, so now let me move to the users. See, in user part, you can see, like, you can do, like, the two activities. One is creating user, another is creating role, okay? So here, like, or apart from these two things, you can see, like, you know, what are the roles available under this section or the users available. So if you see this admin, I have given the description as super admin and I've assigned this role as AE admin. Okay, for the bot creator, which I created, I have given the name, okay, and I have assigned this role. Okay, so here, if you have any existing user and you want to see the details of that user, you can check it from this tab. Okay, now coming to the roles. So by default, this automation anywhere roles section will show you the roles, which is system defined roles. Okay. So by seeing this AAE underscore, you can understand this role is defined by the system. So currently I haven't defined any role here. Okay. So once I defined any role, it will display the details of role here only. Okay. So the AAE underscore, whatever role is starting with this three to name. So you can understand this roles has been defined by the automation anyway. Okay. Now coming back to the license part. So this license part will give you the details about the license installation, the product which you are using, or like whatever you have brought from the automation anyway, like your control room version, whether it's the purchase or trial. So for my scenario, this is 11.3.2.0. And the purchase is showing as a trial. So currently I'm using a trial. Okay. And here you can see the bot, like bot inside analytics, API. So it will give you the details. Like I'm having currently bot creator. Okay. So basically this is a development type of license, which I got three. So I can create three user with the bot creator privilege. So currently I'm using one and I can create two more. Okay. Now you can see, like, you know, attended bot runner. So this license tab will give you the more details about, like, you know, the terms and conditions which your agreement at the time of buying the license. Okay. Now coming to the migration, this migration page will help you to migrate your automation anywhere task from automation anywhere version 10 to 11. Okay, if you click on this migration data, so here you have to fill the details, right? You have to put the repository path, database name, master key. So after filling these details, it will help you to complete the migration. Okay. So this migration part is little bit, you know, critical part. Okay. So in case if you want to migrate, make sure you have to take all the required backups. Then only you start for the migration. Okay. All right. Now coming to this top part. So here you can see from this button, if you want to change your password or if you want to edit your profile, you can go ahead and make the changes from here. So you can see here, currently I logged in with my rp.developers1gmailid.com. So that details I can see from here. And here another part is that you can see the number of languages supported by the automation anywhere. In case if you want to use different language other than English, you can go ahead and change it from here. So this is all about this control room part. Okay, so I mean in upcoming videos I will explain you about more details, like how to create user, how to create roles, how to schedule a bot, and I'll try to create video on the workload management as well. So I hope you like this video and find this video very helpful to understand a basic about the control room. automation anywhere V11. So in case if you have any questions, any suggestion, I would request you to, you can directly mail me, or you can post in a comment section also. And I would request you to kindly subscribe my channel. Okay. Or if you have any suggestions or any ideas, please let me know. All right. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. Thank you.